Now that we know about the anatomical position, we can look at the list of terms that describe relative positions. And I suggest you learn them in pairs. And that's how we will go over them right now. So, deep and superficial are terms that are opposite to each other. Superficial is something that is close to the external aspect of the body, so towards the surface of the body. And deep is when we are referring to something that is close to the internal aspect of the body, so within the body. For example, we can say that the large intestine is deep to the skin, obviously. It's internal. It is deep within the body when we compare to the skin location. At the same time, we can say that the skin is superficial to the muscles of our body, because the muscles are underneath the skin, so the skin is superficial. We have the words superior and inferior. So superior is when something is above, is superior, is towards the head. And inferior is when something is below, so is towards the feet. Other words for superior are cranial or cephalic, because cranial or cephalic, they are in reference to your head, right? So your head is superior to the other structures that you have in your body that are below your head. And inferior can also be called caudal. But caudal can only be used if we're talking within the trunk, because caudal is making a reference to the tail, to the coccyx, the tailbone. And the tailbone is basically at the end of the trunk. So caudal is when we are referring to something that is inferior, but is also posterior, because your cox is posterior, is in the back. So examples for the superior term is that our eyes are superior to the mouth, so it's above the mouth, and our lungs are more cranial than the stomach, because the stomach is in the belly, right? In the abdominal cavity. And the lungs are in the chest, in the thoracic cavity. So the lungs are more cranial, and also they are more superior than the stomach. Examples for the term inferior includes the knee is inferior to the urinary bladder, because the urinary bladder is within the pelvic cavity, and the knee is in between the thigh and the leg. And another example is that the coccyx is caudal to the thoracic vertebrae. So it is inferior, it is caudal to the thoracic vertebrae, which are the vertebrae we have at the thoracic cavity level. Ventral versus dorsal. Another word for ventral is anterior, and another word for dorsal is posterior. Throughout the years, I noticed that some students have a hard time remembering that ventral is anterior and dorsal is posterior. So one way you can do to remember is that ventral starts with the letter V and anterior starts with the letter A. So basically you have the same shape, V and A, right? And the same thing for dorsal and posterior, right? So you have the letter D and then you basically just increase the little stick and then you have the letter P. So dorsal is posterior and ventral is anterior. Now, you notice throughout the semester that if you know any language that has a Latin or Greek origin, that will help you a lot. Because lots of terms and words you will be learning throughout the semester uses Latin and Greek roots. So, for example, if you know how to speak Spanish or Portuguese, you can remember the word vientre or ventre. And those two words, they mean belly. So, if you remember the anatomical position, you can remember that your belly is anterior, right? It's the first thing. So, ventral, vientre, ventre is anterior, and consequently, dorsal is posterior. So, let's go over the definition of the words ventral and dorsal. Something that is ventral or anterior is closer to the front of the body. Looking here at the anatomical position, we can see that the person is facing forward. So the person facing forward tells us that that is the anterior or ventral aspect of the body, and the back will be the dorsal or posterior aspect of the body. An example using the ventral term is that the navel, the belly button, is ventral to the small intestines, because the small intestines are posterior, they are back. When we are looking at a person in anatomical position, the belly button comes first and then the intestines. So the belly button is ventral to the intestines. Now, when you're talking about an example for dorsal or posterior, we can say that the rectum is posterior to the urinary bladder. And if we decide to use the navel and the small intestines, we can say that the small intestines are posterior to the navel. Medial and lateral. Obviously, medial is when we are referring to something that's closer to the midline of the body. So the heart is medial to the lungs. And lateral is when something is away from the midline of the body. So it is towards the sides. Such as the thumb in anatomical position is lateral to the pinky. Because remember, in anatomical position, the palms of your hands face forward. Consequently, your pinky is medial, it is closer to the midline of your body than your thumb. In other words, your thumb is lateral to the pinky. Another pair of terms is proximal and distal. And these two terms, they are always used in relationship to the torso. And they are primarily used when we are looking at our limbs, upper and lower limbs. Now, proximal, as the word says, it's proximal, it's nearby, it's close to the torso. And distal means that it's distant in relationship to the torso. So we can see here that the arm, which is this part, is proximal to the forearm, right? Because the arm is closer to the torso than the forearm. And we can say that the fingers are distal to the arm, because the fingers are further away, more distant from the torso than the arm. So the fingers are distal to the arm. And we could also say that the arm is proximal to the fingers. This diagram summarizes the directional terms, the comparative terms I just went over. And I put this diagram together in order for you to have a very quick reference to all these different comparative terms that we will be using throughout the semester. And this diagram is available for you to download in the description of this video.